Okay, so tonight's class, or this class, was I cracked a really bad joke, and this is going to persist, I think. Anyway, this class was all about barridas, or sweeps. Sweeps are when in tango you do this thing where you look like you're pushing your partner's foot along, but you kind of aren't really. Like so many things in tango, it's a bit of a fake. What you're doing is you lead your partner forwards and block, and then you slowly turn back with the chest, but you take your foot with hers. So it looks as though I'm pushing her foot off. But actually, even if I didn't do that, her foot would go there anyway. And it's all because my frame is moving. So we looked at various ways of doing some sweeps and barridas and things. The key thing to remember is it's all about chest connection, about transfer of weight, and about what would happen naturally anyway, even if my foot wasn't there. So it's not about me shoving her foot around. What I'm not doing, for example, is I'm not sort of sending her into a ocho, I'm not getting there, and I'm not just going, because I'm pushing her foot. Yeah, that wouldn't work. What I have to do is I have to actually lead with the chest, and I have to lead her into the movement that she would be taking anyway, and then my foot goes with hers. Now, we talk about the unwritten rules of tango, and I promise that one of these days I'm going to write down all the unwritten rules of tango, so they are no longer unwritten rules.
They'll become the written rules,
indeed. The written rules of tango, or soon to be written rules of tango. One of them is that if you're in one of these barrida sweep connection things, both follower and leader, if you feel that there is that connection there, particularly followers, don't just break it for the sake of it. Yes, if you're going to fall over, if you're losing your balance, or if the chest lead is too fast related to the speed of the foot, then by all means step away. But if you feel that connection, you kind of go with it and keep a little bit of pressure on it. So what's happening is, so as I lead her back, she's basically resisting very slightly. So I am pushing into her foot. She is pushing back into mine, but it's all being led by the chest. It takes some practice to get it right. It took us ages to get it right as well. Particularly the other one. By the way, I'm not really just going through the sequence of things that we did in the class. I'm just picking up highlights of what matters. So if you're trying to remember the actual routine you did in the class, I can't actually remember the routine you did in the class, which is why I'm not filming it. But all the key points were... Should I have admitted that one again? Anyway... A week ago, okay. Yeah, come on. So we... When you go that way, it's important to keep the connection. But when you go this way, it's even more important to keep the connection. And basically, I'm still leading her with my chest and my frame and everything. But now, I'm letting her push my foot. Now, I'm keeping contact. As one of the guys said tonight, it's basically just letting my free leg stay free and just going with her free leg that is being driven by my movement of frame. So, it's all about keeping connection and just making sure it's there. It works if your balance is right. You've got to make sure your balance is very definitely on the foot when you're moving, so you can't be split weight, otherwise it becomes... And that's no fun. And doesn't look much like tango. So yeah, anyway, those are the key elements.